What's going on, guys? It's David here, and today we are going into another review video of the Reebok Nano 11. This is just going to be a first impressions, a first look, my take, my thoughts, to give you guys a little bit of helpful insight into whether or not you should purchase the Reebok Nano 11. And with that, let's go ahead and hop into today's video. Also, do me a favor, and if you enjoy today's video and find it informative and helpful, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe and comment, and let me know your guys' thoughts. All right, guys, so this month, Reebok has finally released the Reebok Nano 11, which is a very sharp departure from what we've seen on the previous models, let alone the 10th model. This is a really interesting shoe just in terms of how they decided to go in this direction. So we're gonna hop into all the highlights, the lowlights, and then finally at the end, we're gonna talk a little bit about my opinions on if you should purchase this shoe. All right, guys, so here it is. We've got the Nano 11. This shoe I picked up about 2 weeks ago. And so I've had about a week to kind of play around with it and test it out and see what it is that I like about it, and just kind of overall initial thoughts. One of the things, the first things that you're gonna notice with this that's way different than previous models is the upper. The upper has been completely redesigned based off of what we've seen in prior models and shoes. With the 11, we have what they still call flex weave, but what you'll find is that it's a little bit more of like a knit fabric as opposed to the 10, which has more of like a cable knit. It's kind of hard to see. The 11 or the 10 has a little bit more of like a cable knit plastic upper for, you know, what we call flex weave. For the 11, this one is gonna be a little bit more of like a knit fabric. With this, the one thing that kind of concerns me overall is just the durability when it comes to weather. If you're gonna be running in this in the rain, I really honestly don't think that this would really hold up compared to the 10 here, which has a little bit more of like a weather repellent type material. This knit fabric is definitely going to get soaked. I don't know if they plan to do other versions of this flex weave, but again, just right off the back, I will say that this is something to be cautious of as you're looking for or looking to purchase or potentially pick up this shoe. All right, so the next biggest change in terms of design is the tongue. The tongue on the 10 or the 11 is no longer, essentially the best way for me to describe it is it no longer has that inner booty style inner like what we saw on the 10. For here on the 11, the tongue is not connected. It's a little hard to see. You'll be able to see in the little detail shot that I included. The tongue is not connected to the shoe. So it feels very loose as opposed to in the 10. The tongue was attached. It's a little hard to see here, but the tongue is attached to the sidewall. And so the tongue doesn't flop around as much on the 10, but whereas on the 11, the tongue just kind of like falls all over the place. I would say one thing you will need to kind of be aware of is that you will maybe need to readjust your shoes as you're wearing them over time, or just tighten your shoes down so tight that the tongue doesn't move, but it could be an annoyance for some people. I honestly prefer the tongue on the 10 as opposed to the 11, just because I tend to wear my shoes a little bit looser. I like knowing that the way that my shoe is constructed, that it has that booty-like feel. That has that booty-like feel. And so it's a little bit more of like a snugger fit. I will say that with the 11, it's not so much as a snug fit, and that's because the tongue just moves around and flops around a lot. All right, so some more details about this upper. We have the reinforced eyelets, very similar to what we saw on the 10. The other thing here with these ones are more of like the same material, I guess you could say, that's used in like weather sealing, I guess you could say. So it's a little bit smoother. It's not as fabricy. The laces, this was the, I think it's the Call Me Backpack, I think is what it's called. This one is slightly different. So on the inside you have like Do Not Disturb. We all know what that reference is. Then we also have reinforced sidewalls for lateral stability type movements. We also have something that I'm really excited about, and that's the addition of a heel counter for doing handstand push-ups. So this wasn't something that was typically in any of the other models, but we've seen it in previous models. We've seen it in the Reebok Nano Sprint TR, which came out a while back, a very, very long time ago. But they never really translated that into any other Reebok Nano shoe. So this is the first time that we are getting this handstand push-up counter, so you can get a little bit of that like frictionless slide when you are doing your handstand push-ups. There's also a TPU heel counter, and those are the main things that's going on with the upper of the shoe. Overall, in terms of the technology, I think it's really great, especially for the lateral movements, having that stability. The handstand push-up counter, I think, is a big thing. I think a lot of people are gonna like that and may not have necessarily noticed that was incorporated into the 11. All right, next we've got the outsole that's been pretty much completely redesigned. In previous models, Reebok was using what was called MetaSplit. Now with the 11, they've added FloatRide Energy, which I'll talk about a little bit shortly. But with that, they've kind of redesigned the midsole and the outsole. So with the outsole, you don't see that old school pattern that used to be like on the 11, which has the MetaSplit. As you can see there, so it's completely different. Another big change is the Rope Pro technology. So on the 10 and below, it's a little bit different to where it's a little bit more like seamlessly integrated into the shoe. Whereas, obviously this is integrated into the shoe, but the thing that I'm kind of not stoked on is that there is a lip to this Rope Pro that they've got going on here. So my concern would be that over time, and potentially a lot sooner rather than later, you may potentially see the outsole on these fall apart. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a lot of people that end up leaving reviews on this stating that this part of the shoe did come undone, but it is a significant change from the previous models, so something to keep in mind. But outside of that, I don't think you'll see too much of a big change with this outsole. It should be relatively the same sort of experience. But with the midsole, that is where you are going to see a big change. What we have now is the incorporation of FloatRide Energy. And that is what their running technology, or Reebok has used in their running technology. I think it's in, they have a shoe that's called the FloatRide. And in most of their other running shoes. It's supposed to provide a little bit better of a cushioning experience as opposed to the 10 or any of the other shoes that didn't have the FloatRide technology, while still being able to provide you with that stable platform while lifting and doing everything that you want to do. So I don't believe the entire footbed uses the FloatRide Energy, but a majority of it, at least in the forefront and the back, and then in the middle, it is probably most likely EVA or some sort of like dual density type, or some sort of plastic or something of that nature. So that's going to be a big change. That's something that I kind of noticed when I was using this shoe, but it is something, again, to keep in mind. You might find this to be a little bit more comfortable compared to the older models of Nano, specifically even the 10, which I think the 10 was a lot more comfortable than the 9, in my opinion. A lot of people might not agree with me, but that was my opinion. I really liked the 10 compared to the 9, and the 11 also has quite a bit of comfort as well. Some other things you guys might be interested in, the difference in weight compared to the 9 and the 10. The 10 and the 11. The Nano 11 weighs about 11 ounces as well, compared to the 10 that weighs about 13 ounces. So you're gonna also notice a really huge difference in terms of weight, especially when you're doing running movements or any sort of movements that require you to do a lot of jumping and running and, you know, maybe box jumps, burpees, things of that nature. So this is a really, really stupid light shoe. You notice it. I noticed it instantly when I put this shoe on. The one thing I will say though, and this is gonna kind of shift over into now more of my overall thoughts with this shoe, It's really light, but I feel like a lot of the bells and whistles that I really enjoyed with the 11 were kind of stripped away in terms of just like overall shoe experience. Yes, this is a pretty responsive shoe, but I think that in terms of like the overall durability, which is very important to me, I use my shoes for years and years and years. I still wear my fours to this day, and those I think were built crazy good. Those are probably one of my favorite pairs of nanos. But with this nano, the upper is the thing that I feel like they stripped away a lot of the weight and a lot of the material that went into this shoe. So it probably cost less to build this shoe, but you're getting less durability out of it. I don't know if that makes sense. And that's the one thing that I'm afraid of, especially with this upper. I can't see myself wearing this shoe in the rain or in any sort of condition that's going to cause my foot to potentially get wet. I could be wrong, but I honestly don't want to take the chance with the way that this is constructed. Even the tongue of the shoe is very, very porous in terms of the overall protection that you would hope to see. It's kind of iffy. It's very iffy. I mean, if you're looking at this 10, again, the upper is just very well constructed in terms of sealing and weathering. The tongue on the 11 is also very porous, but I would say it feels a little bit more like it's got a little bit more of higher quality construction to it than the 11. And just overall, I think just the materials in the 10 are way better. So if I had to honestly give like my opinion onto whether or not you should like go out and buy this, to be honest, I don't think the shoe is worth going after at this price, especially right now. The 10 is available right now. You could still buy it. If anything, I would say definitely stock up on the 10 as opposed to buying the 11. Yes, this is a lighter shoe. Yes, this is a shoe that has the handstand push-up heel counter. Yes, this has the lateral sidewall stability. But honestly, in terms of durability, this isn't a shoe that I'm going to buy another pair of, to be quite honest, unless it's like a colorway that I really want. In my opinion, I think the 10 was a way better constructed shoe overall. Yes, it is a little bit heavier, but this shoe is gonna last you a lot better than this shoe will last you. That's just my opinion. I could be wrong. You could ask, you know, Joel from as many reviews as possible. He might have a different take on that. I haven't seen any of his videos yet, but I'm sure he might even have a more thorough video than mine is. Mine is just an initial 1 week overview of this shoe. I do hope Reebok does do other versions of this shoe that do provide a little bit more durability, and I'm going to be looking for that. But again, as of right now, I don't plan on buying another shoe, another 11. I do plan on buying some Nikes. I did see the React Turbo, which looks pretty dope, and I think that might restore my faith in Nike. But we'll see. So that's going to be it for this video. It's a very first impression type video and unboxing for this shoe. Let me know down below what your guys' thoughts are. Have you bought this shoe? Are you thinking about this shoe? What other questions that you guys have? Let me know in the comments down below. Again, please love and like this video. Subscribe if you enjoyed this video as well. And with that, guys, I will catch you in the next video. May your barbells be heavy and your coffee be black. This is David, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.